All right, guys, so like I said, you don't need to know the mechanism of this reaction. What we do need to know is what bonds are being broken and what bonds are being made. All right? So on my reagent side, okay, reagents, what I have is the bonds that are breaking. Because what I can see is that I used to have a CH bond here, but now that's turning into CBr. So that means that at some point I must have broken that bond, okay? So that means that this is going to be the breaking side, okay? If this is the breaking side, what sign of enthalpy should this have? Should it be positive or negative? It should be positive, right? Because it's taking energy to make these bonds come apart. So all of the values that I put over here are going to be positive, all right? Then all the values I put over here for the making side are going to be negative, because these are ones that are going to release energy into the system. So now all I have to do is identify these bonds, okay? One of them I know already is going to be CH3H. I know that bond is getting broken because right now I see, like I said, it used to be there and now it isn't. Another one that has to get broken is Br2, because Br2 is turning into HBr. So this is going to be BrBr. That's another one that's going to require energy to break. Now let's look at my negative charge. I mean, not charge, my negative side, my exothermic side. So basically, the bonds that I'm making are equal to CH3Br, because that's a new bond that didn't exist before. And another one is HBr. That's a bond that didn't exist before. So now all I have to do is pull down the values from my chart, and whichever ones are on my reagent side are going to be, or my breaking side are going to be positive. Whichever ones are on my product side or my making side are going to be negative. So let's go ahead and look up. So what are the values that I'm bringing down? Well, the CH3H is going to be 436, so it's going to be positive 436. BrBr is going to be, it looks like, where is that? It's right here. So that's going to be 192, positive 192. Okay. Then on the negative side, or on the making side, CH3Br, I'm going to just take myself out of the screen for a second so you guys can see. So on the negative side, CH3Br is going to be right here, that's going to be 923, so I'm going to give that a negative 923. And then HBr is going to be negative 368. Okay, so now I'm pulling it back down, we have all the values we need. Hi, I'm back. So now all we need to do is plug all these values into a calculator, and whatever our end answer is, that's going to be the end answer. And I'm here, sorry about that. Stop autofocusing. Okay, so let's go ahead. I've got my calculator here. Let's go ahead and enter these values. I have 436 plus 192 minus 293 minus 368. And what that should give you at the end is that your enthalpy, your delta H, is equal to negative 33 kilojoules per mole. All right, so that's going to answer a really big question for us. Is this exothermic or is this endothermic? And the answer is that this has to be exothermic, because at the end, the sum of my bond association energies is actually going to be a negative number, which means that I'm getting more stable at the end. I'm making more bonds, or I'm gaining more energy than I'm losing by breaking those bonds. So this would be an exothermic reaction. Do you know if this would be a spontaneous reaction? No, we have no clue yet. We still need the temperature and the delta S to figure that out. But we know with certainty that this is an exothermic reaction. Okay? Now I want you guys to do the same thing for the second question. Once again, all on your own, try to figure it out, and then I'll give you guys the answer.